Why are we walking?
People haven't always lived the way we do now. Since ancient times, we have changed our customs and lifestyles. The very first human beings were nomads just like we are, but that was for their survival and not their choice. And then, as many of them started to settle in places that they considered to be comfortable, life began to get easier, but it was never enough. Throughout history, we have always followed the dream of what we thought was progress, always searching for new limits to set, somehow certain that all of this was natural. One of these limits was represented by distance. Mankind has always felt the need to move as quickly as possible. So to step from riding on animals, building the fastest of machines, was rapid. Desire burned and technology advanced. And then it happened. The invention of the teleport.
What's a teleport?
A port that can take you anywhere within a matter of seconds. Oh, you wouldn't believe how many there were. They were all over the known lands, set up in grids. Everywhere.
How are they made?
You are an inquisitive boy. Look, down there, beside that rock, there's one of the last ports in this area. And that's where we're going. You have to know that there were public ones and private ones too, but to use these, you needed a special authorization. The very first ports were installed in the main city squares, but there were only a few of them available to begin with. This caused long waiting times for the user, and it was often quicker to use the normal means of travel. The first protest movements rose up. Others were afraid of misuse after a series of connected terrorist attacks occurred. Then a strong ethical opposition rose, demanding it was unacceptable that teleportation meant a person once scanned by the initial port would be disintegrated and then reproduced on arrival at their destination. All that was teleported was the user's information into their reproductions. Maybe this is a little complicated. Anyway, all other difficulties, once solved, contributed to improve and fortify the systems. And while discussions about the rights and wrongs were still going on, teleportation had become a reality that people soon couldn't live without. It's a little complex, but use your imagination. In the past, something known as the internet was invented, a connection able to link anyone to any information. It was extremely powerful, and you could do countless things with it. And by the time the teleport had arrived, we could control it with our minds. Just imagine, with one thought, you could decide where to go. So, have you decided where you want to go? Then enter the port. It's scanning you now to check if you've got any dangerous items on you.
Thank you.
And how was it?
The water was super cool.
Now I'm going to tell you the rest of the story. As you can understand, because of teleportation, there was no need to live close to each other anymore. So cities died and slowly disappeared as people scattered all over. It actually worked for a long time, and it was a brilliant time for humanity. But then, because of some belief that the last frontier had been reached, things changed again. This time inside man's spirit, they had become man-machine hybrids, alone in the universe, with powers of gods. But they had lost what was theirs since the dawn of time. They had forgotten the meaning of living, the important experience of each step we take. For centuries, it had become infinitively more difficult to appreciate the importance of just this little stone and all the rest of this than to build crystal towers, flying machines, or even to cross the universe. This is the greatest achievement of our time.
But what happened?
People started to realize what they had sacrificed. So like a sandcastle under the sun, everything fell apart. All that was conquered was abandoned. Humanity returned. This is why we walk. Because we are human.
Subscribe to Dust for new sci-fi every week.